Our life together is so precious. Together we have grown. We have grown. Although our love is still special.
In 1980, after a period of relative inactivity, John Lennon would release his album Double Fantasy, a record that was supposed to mark a resurgence in his career, but tragically would end up marking the end of his life.
It's been too long since we took the time. No one's to blame. I know time flies so quickly.
Double Fantasy was a collaborative effort between John Lennon and Yoko Ono, where they would combine their individual approach to songwriting into a single project. And while over 40 years has passed since the release of the album, I still find that every time I listen to it, I still pick up that the emotion and the vulnerability that they would share through their music. The impact of the album really can't be overstated, and it's been cited as an influence for a number of artists ranging from U2 to Green Day, and to some extent has really become an essential touchstone within the history of rock music.
People say I'm crazy.
John and Yoko had a history of sharing very personal aspects of their relationship within their art and their message. Take, for example, 1968, they would pose nude for their Two Virgins album, and in 1969, they would have their bed in protest. So Double Fantasy is just a continuation of this history of sharing. In this case, they would take very personal and introspective aspects of their life, and they would share them through their lyrics.
Close your eyes. Have no fear. The monster's gone. He's on the run, and your daddy's here. Beautiful, 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 beautiful boy.
And thinking about the evolution of rock through the 1980s, considering the impact of MTV, the second British invasion, and new wave, the rise of hair rock, I can't help but wonder how the influence of John Lennon would have continued to shape pop and rock had he lived. After all, Double Fantasy has remained a very important and influential album. Alright, so check this out because it's pretty cool. The original studio session for I'm Losing You would actually include Cheap Trick's Rick Nielsen and Bunny Carlos on guitar and drums, and Tony Levin on bass.
Me play what I wanted to play, and John said, "Rick, just play what you're doing. It sounds terrific." And he went in the booth, and this is a quote from Bunny. Bunny said that John looked at him and said, "God, I wish I had Rick on Cold Turkey." He said, "Clapped and choked up."
You know, the passing of John Lennon's not just some distant memory for me. It was probably the first very significant, you know, cultural event that would leave an impact on me. You know, looking back, my memories of the day that it was announced, it shifted. The colors in my memories are different. In fact, I remember going to the grocery store with my mother that day, and while I was probably too young to really understand what had taken place, I do distinctly remember just everything was different. So to this day, whenever I listen to the songs of that album, they still continue to stir very, very emotional and poignant feelings within me. So how about you?